All right, finally back. Been like 2 weeks or so. Today we got another guest. What do we call you? Middle buck or something? Middle badger. That's what we called him. This is Jeffrey. He's requested a few songs for us, such as Fozzy, which did not get a lot of love, which he does not like us for.
They're haters.
So we brought him on today to pick a song that he enjoys, I guess. And we're going to go ahead and see what we think. So you got anything to say about that?
You want to set it up?
You just want to go ahead hit play?
Yeah.
Go ahead. I mean, you got anything to say about it first? Or you?
I mean, I think it's a great song, but Okay. Given that you guys trashed my last pick, I'm going to say that
you guys
might have another wrong opinion, but, you know,
another wrong
it is
opinion.
What it is.
You know what they say about opinions.
Yeah.
Assholes.
Here we go.
Hit play. Let's get it.
I can see you standing, honey, with his arms around your body, laughing, but the joke's not funny at all. And it took you 5 whole minutes to pack us up and leave me with it, holding all this love out here in the hall. I think I've seen this film before, and I didn't like the ending. You're not my homeland anymore, so what am I defending now? You were my town, now I'm in exile seeing you out. I think I've seen this film before.
I never learned to read your mind.
All right, well, we always let the guest give us his rundown.
I already told you what I think of it.
Well, I mean, you don't really expound upon that at all?
Well, I just think that their harmonies together, for one, I think that makes an amazing song. I think the lyrics where, like, one part is, like, he's saying that he never had any signs, and then she's like, I gave you so many signs, and, like, it's like that whole back and forth. It's almost like a relationship where they're, like, arguing back and forth.
Yeah.
So, I like I said, it's one of my personal favorites of a Taylor Swift song, so...
I got a feeling Young Lion is not going to be a big fan.
Yep, Lil Song was a little too slow for me, personally. But we know how I feel about slow songs. That's what got me hate on this man right here.
Which is, that's a whole other story.
But nonetheless, I think I do agree with Jeffrey that the song, they did harmonize really good. I don't know who that other fella is. I know who Taylor Swift is, but I don't know who the other guy is. But I think they did harmonize really good. And I think overall, the lyrics was pretty good. And... you don't see piano a whole lot, and I did like very prominently, I guess, in the song, and it was really good in there. I liked it.
Yeah.
Well, you got Pops.
For me, I really liked it. I like the I'm more like the lyrics. I'm always like more into the words, and I think like what you said. I like how they're harmonizing back and forth, and how he was saying, "I gave you," or "you never even gave a sign," and she's like, "I gave so many signs," which is pretty indicative of male female. Relationships, how they're not really on the same wavelength, and they come to an end. So, anyone that's dealt with any sort of like heartbreak or whatever should be able to identify with the song. But yeah, I'm digging it. You'd have to be in the mood for it because it's kind of a sad song in a way.
Yeah, it's definitely got a
Taylor has a very, she's kind of like that. She's either super poppy and upbeat or. Yeah. Very sad, but those deep cuts, man.
Yeah.
Lyrical.
It reminds me of one song I used to listen to way back in the day, but I can't remember the name of it. But I wish I could. It reminded me. I wish I could.
Who's it by?
I don't even know. But it was really hitting me there for a while. But anyone that's like older than like Young Lion over here, and you've had your heart broke a couple times, you're gonna identify and have those moments where you kind of get into the blues. The bluesy feel, the depressed feel of there's nothing quite like a heartbreak, so yeah, I dig. I like the interplay between the male and the female, and I like how his version and her version, and it's over. That's it. It's a done deal. So for me, I would have to probably give this song. If you're in the mood for it, like if you're going through like a heartbreak or whatever. Which right at this exact time, oddly enough, I'm like getting divorced. So for me, I guess you could hit pretty well at home. So I'm gonna give it a solid 8.
Wow, big numbers. What do you got? What do you give this song?
I give it a 9. It's one of my all-time favorites.
Strong choice. I'm gonna give it a 7. So 7, 8, 9.
Honestly, for you not liking slow songs, that's not bad.
I like the words.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Word so there man. You got it. Yeah.